Hey everyone, Kyle once again, welcome back to another review. And like the previous one I did for Ready for Math with Pooh. Let me show it again. Now it's time for me to give my 20th anniversary review of the other one. Which, well, I said it's like explained, childhood game I grew up loving playing. And so now it's the next one. So it's Ready to Read with Pooh. And then like the other one, this is like the newer look CD-ROM cover for this. But I used to have the old one for the math one, though, but not anymore. But luckily, I still have this one. This is what the old CD-ROM cover looks like. See the difference here? Yeah. This is the look I always loved looking the cover for. And showed here what the old, on the back here for the old games right here. This is what the old Ready for Math one looked like. And yeah, there's other games right here, like one for the Timon and Pumbaa one or the Aladdin ones. Never got those ones, never played them. It was only the Ready for Math one that I always played with, and along with this one. So yeah, this is what the old new one looks like, but I'll hold up the old one. So yeah. So my 20th anniversary review for Ready to Read with Pooh. Love this game still. I still play it to this day, like I did with the other one. And like the other one, it helped growing up playing, just teach me, taught me the little ways of reading and all this stuff. It really did. And just like the villain Pooh, which is also, once again, I forgot to mention the voice. Once again, voiced by Jim Cummings. And I always enjoy, plus once again, enjoy the voice cast of the games as well. And also, forget to mention how each opening for both these games is Pooh floating on his balloon, saying "Here we go, floating anywhere we," you know, just like he did for both, like he did for the other for the old show. And now, also enough for this one, like how the for math one, he wants to build a garden. Well, here it's like, you know, discovers like an old tree house. And it's like, I've never seen this one before. This must be yours. The one referring to the you as one playing the game. So he wants you to help, you know, spruce up this tree, you know, this tree house to make it livable. And so now for both these games. For the slightest one I loved more by slightly was this one. I love the math one, I do. But just by a slight edge, because I played this game first before the second one. This one I love just by the slight edge of it. And now for the classic, I would call it these games are so classic. I call them classic activities I just love to play with. To help you with the reading part, some of the activities, like, let's start with Roo. You go to, like, Roo's little, thinking spot, where you have, like, sand statues of Tigger, Piglet, and Eeyore, and you could pick anyone you want, any character, and, pick any of these items, like, for instance, like, instruments. Like there's like statues of instruments. Like you can pick any of these three characters and let them choose any of these instruments and where Roo thinks of, like, says, for instance, like, or any sporting stuff as well, like a basketball or something like that. Like you can pick anyone, and like, for instance, you can choose Tigger and a basketball, and Roo thinks Tigger plays with a basketball, or Piglet plays with basketball, or Eeyore, etc. And any, you can pick any characters for anything that's lying there, and Roo can think of it in a sentence. So basically, sentence construction, basically. And for another activity, where you go to Piglet's, you go to Piglet's house, and it's like letter matching, you know, like a memory game. Where you open one cabinet and it's a uppercase letter, and then you have to match it with a lowercase letter of the same letter. So like W, you know, matching memory game of his plates in his cabinets. And yeah, upper and lowercase letters. This was supposed to be. And for another good one where you go to a Pooh's house, where you sort Pooh's honeypots in alphabetical order, letter order, all of Pooh's honeypots. Or another case where you where Tigger where he gets stuck in a tree, and you have to make this quilt, where you have to each quilt has four pictures of different things, and you have to create a patchwork in the quilt of words to help Tigger get down the tree. Like, for instance, like on the back of here, it shows the back of here, like four pictures of different things. You have to put a letter for each word to make the word. So, for him to get down. That's another good activity that I like. And, or you go to Eeyore's books, where there's torn little pages of pictures of things where, in a sentence, like, for instance, like back here, you can see it, the sheep laughs, and you take that, where you look at one of the torn pictures and put it into that book. So give Eeyore a hand in putting his book together by matching words and pictures. And then another one where you go to Rabbit's house, and we had to draw words, you know, draw using like a paintbrush or Tigger's contraption to make boards with words and that are where the letters are polka dotted, and you need to take the paintbrush and you have to draw each letter to make the word. For instance, like cow. You know, all the letters for the word are dotted. You need to use the paintbrush to go each dot to connect each one to make a letter and to form the whole word. And, well, not the whole entire word. It's for you know, draw your letters, for all 26 letters. And each letter that you do will light up for you to do all 26 letters, each one for the alphabet on a word, basically. So, like, for instance, like, cow. And the one you have to paint is the letter C. C will be dotted out for the word. Not the whole word, just the letter C. And that's a good C that you made. And it's also funny, if you would paint for each letter, per word, Tigger sometimes, which I find funny, he sometimes gets, like, the letters mixed up for another word. And Rabbit has to correct, it's like, Tigger says, gee, what a nice Y, or there's a letter, and Rabbit says, no, Tigger, that is a, like a Z or Q, wherever the letter is. So yeah. So that activity, painting letters, drawing letters, basically. And like I said, and after each activity, there's three stages per activity, and gets a little harder, and after when you do all the stages, Gopher has something to take back to the treehouse. And then it comes to my three favorite stages of the game, three of them, my three favorites of all of them. And why I would still say it's my three favorite games, both of the math and reading game. One of my favorites is the one that says on the back here where, we help Tigger match sounds with letters to make the jack-in-the-boxes pop. So, like, back here. Where you click on one jack-in-the-box and Tigger will make the sound for each letter. Like, for one instance, for one blank jack-in-the-box, one goes like, la, 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 la. And you take the letter that's on the log that sounds like it, and you put it on the jack-in-the-box and it'll pop up saying, like, L. L, lollipop, or H, like ha 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 ha, like take one the like the letter H and put it on that box and it'll pop out. It's like H, huh, horsey, Yeah, like that. Matching letters with the sounds of the Jack in the Box. That's I love that activity as well. And by the way, for a while I thought that was Paul Winchell who voiced Tigger, but it turns out it's Jim Cummings. Which Jim Cummings, who always does good, as does the exact same voice of Tigger though. But Paul Winchell, for me, he's always been the best voice of Tigger, like he did for the New Adventures of Winnie the Pooh and the old ones as well. Yeah, to me, Paul Winchell, Jim Cummings does great as voicing, like he did for the 2011 film and so forth afterward, after Paul Winchell passed away. I do give credit to Jim Cummings doing a great job of voicing Tigger, but to me, Paul Winchell will always be the good voice of Tigger as well. Always will be. But around the time I thought that while I was playing this game growing up, I thought it was Paul Winchell who voiced Tigger, but it turns out it's Jim Cummings. So yeah. And then the next activity that I love was where Tigger goes to Owl's house, and Owl does his poems, like it rhymes, and like you have to, like end of each sentence, you have to take that letter, that word, and put the end of the sentence to make it match with the. For instance, like poor rabbit had a scare had a when he lived to the rug. When he lifted the rug, he saw a blank, which means it's a bug. Because bug rhymes with rug. To take that bug word, makes it rhymes with the word rug. And each time each time you do one, like Tigger plays a piano to make it sound. And I thought it was kind of funny sometimes I purposely don't match it right and get it wrong. Tigger hits the piano like bump. When you get it wrong, it makes a confused or disgusted look on his face, and it makes me laugh. And then when you get to my all-time favorite one of both these games, my all-time favorite one is when we go to Tigger's house and he does like his Detective Tigger, where he just solve the mystery of who done it. That's my all-time favorite activity out of both these games. I love where you get to go to Tigger's house and do his Detective Tigger and get to detect some of who did it. And also for this activity, for each one stage that you do, the three stages, there is like a certificate you can print out. Now, I printed the like I last time I played the this well since then I remember playing it back in 2009, because after all these years I never got to print those certificates out. And by the beginning of 2009, I printed three of those certificates to when you did each of those activities, the three stages of that level of that game, and I did frame those ones because, hey, I never got a chance to print those growing up, so I got a chance to print them back in 2009, so I actually have those certificates nicely framed, and that's really true. So yeah. That's my favorite activity, Detective Tigger at his house. So yeah, I love this game so much, and same with Brave for Math with Pooh. One of my favorite video games I loved growing up, and especially one of my all-time favorite CD-ROM games. I'll never get tired of playing these games. It's always something that I can play just to reference back my childhood, because I love Winnie the Pooh. That's the once again showing the math one. Here's like then show the new one and the old one, but I'll just show the old one because that's what I have, like the old one. So yeah, Rage to Read with Pooh, classic. Same with the math one. Both of them are classic, but this one, for both of them, slightly edge. I enjoy this game teensy bit more, but still I love the math one game though. But yeah, so different reviews. 20th anniversary, another thing for you to review for 20th anniversary, because both of these were released in 97. So yeah, both of those, so I guess, so yeah, definitely worth reviewing for 20th anniversary reviews for. And I haven't, and for as for movie reviews going on, I'm still gonna review for my birth, for my and it's also the thing I've reviewed to review for my birthday month, something I loved playing growing up. So yeah, another good thing I have to review for my birthday month of June. Now as reviews going, I'm still gonna review Event Horizon, and then The Island, and then the other one, Deep Blue Sea. Those are still coming up. And next one, the next review that I pre-recorded, because I could tell it was pre-recorded because my hair wasn't this as messed up it is. So this next one, I pre-recorded, and it's a rant. Because I reviewed the dinner movie because I had to take some time to indulge what I saw. So stay tuned for the pre-recorded rant I did. So stay tuned. That's be uploaded next after these two here. So, and I know some people are gonna be a little mad though, but like I said, it's all my opinion though. I know a lot of people like the film, and that's why I get into debates over with my brother with. But as a lot of people enjoy the film, same with critics though. But it's all my opinion though. So to me, I did not like it, and as I knew what I expected because. So yeah, so stay tuned for that next review, the next movie review, but hope you enjoyed my little reviews of these, because, hey, different take of reviews I do for video games. So yeah, both these are classic, so you can check out this review, and then check out this is what I'm doing right now. If anyone's not played these games, if anyone has this old computer game to play these games, check them out if you have. So hope you enjoyed my reviews for Ray for Math with Pooh and Ray to Read with Pooh. Definitely worth reviewing for 20th anniversary movie review. I keep on saying movies. I'm used to saying that again. I'm still saying it. Definitely worth reviewing 20th anniversary reviews for these games, because they're both released in 97. So, childhood classics. Love it. I still play them to this day. To this day, I'll never get bored of it. So yeah. But thanks for watching. And stay tuned on the next next review is the pre-recorded rant that I did. So I hope you all looking forward to that now. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for that. Later.